Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you another new feature in Stata 16, extended regression models for panel data. Extended regression models allow you to simultaneously account for endogenous covariates, sample selection, and endogenous treatment. Extended regression models with panel data allow you to fit models for continuous outcomes, binary outcomes, ordered outcomes, as well as censored outcomes. Let's look at a quick example using the NLS work data. You can download this data set by typing webuse NLS work. And here below I've described some of the variables in the data set. The variable ID code is an ID for each employee. We also have the natural log of wages, the age of each employee, as well as indicators for union membership and living in the southern United States. Next, let's list the observations for person 1. So here we can see that the first 12 observations are all from person 1, and we have measured their log of wages from the age of 18 to the age of 37. And we also have their union membership and whether they live in the South or not. So let's fit a simple extended regression model for these panel data. I'm going to go to Statistics and scroll down to Longitudinal and Panel Data. And then I'm going to select Endogenous Covariates, and then Models Adding Selection and Treatment. And then I'll select linear regression. And this opens the xteregress dialog box. At the very top of the model tab, we see this button here that says panel settings. So I'm going to click this button and notice that ID code and year are already filled in. These data have already been xt set. But if they hadn't been, you would need to tell Stata about the ID variable and the time variable. So I'm just going to click OK here. And notice in the results window, that issued the command xt set ID code year, just to reiterate that. Now in the rest of the model tab, let's just explore a bit here before we build our model. Notice that I have endogenous covariates here at the top as an option, so I can check that box if I want. I also have an option here for treatment, and if I check that box, that allows me to select features of the treatment features of the model. And then I also have a box at the bottom that I can check to tell Stata about the details of sample selection. So we're just going to fit a fairly basic model just to illustrate the panel data aspects of this. So I'm going to select, click dependent variable and select log of wages as my dependent variable. For my independent variables, I'm going to do something kind of clever. I'm going to click this little three-dot box here. And then I'd like to include age, both the main effective age and age squared. So I'm going to select two-way full factorial, and then I'm going to select age twice. And for both of these, I want to treat age as continuous, and so I'm going to check the box underneath the C dot to make them both continuous. And when I click the button that says Add to Var List, now it's included this statement, C dot age, sharp sharp C dot age. And what this is going to do, or pound pound, or hashtag, whatever, what this is going to do is include age as both a main effective age as well as age squared in my model. So I can click OK and go back to the main dialog box. The next thing I want to do is check this box next to endogenous covariates. And let's say that I have a covariate like tenure that I believe is an endogenous covariate. I can click Create here and build a model for the variable tenure. So tenure is right here. This is going to be my endogenous covariate. And then I can set up another model for the endogenous covariate. And here, again, I'm going to, let's use the three-dot box again because it makes this really easy. I'm going to select two-way full factorial, and again I'm going to select age twice for both of these, and check the box next to continuous, or underneath the C-dot, and click Add to Var List. Next, I do want to add a couple of other categorical variables. I'd like to add union. So here's union, and I'm going to uncheck the box for C because this is a categorical variable, and click Add to Var List. And then I'm going to click or select South, which is right here, and also click Add to Var List. And so this will set up the endogenous covariate part of my model. So next I'm going to click OK. And then I'm going to click OK here at the bottom. We're not going to worry about treatment and sample for this example. And then this is going to take a minute or so to run. These are quite complex models, and they will take a minute or two to run. So don't be discouraged. Just be patient. Okay, so let's scroll back up and take a look at the command. So the command is xteregress. The dependent variable that we're really interested in is log of wages. And then we have age and age squared in our model. And then we also have the endogenous option here. And if we had a treatment option or a selection option, we could include that here as well. So let's scroll down and take a look at our output. Here at the top, we see the coefficients for the model for log of wages, which includes tenure, our endogenous covariate. And then we see another set of coefficients for the model for tenure in our model. So let's scroll down. Notice we also see the variance of the error terms for each of the models, as well as the correlation between the errors for each of those models. And then we also have random effects, the variance of the random effects for each of the two models, as well as the correlation between the random effects. So these xteregress allows you to fit some very sophisticated models. If you'd like to learn more about these, you can visit our website and download the manual and read more about them. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.